Hey guys, my name is Michael. I'm the developer of this game called Voxel MRT, and today I want to show you how to actually play it. There are some other videos on YouTube where you can see how people play it, but most of them play it for the first time, and obviously they don't really know what to do. So I want to show you what to do. So first of all, you can customize your character right here. I want to play with this two-handed sword guy. I like him the most, but there are other options like the archer, the mage, and this guy with two knives. You can also change the design of your character. I like this one. I don't really look like this, but I think it looks cool. There are some options like this one and this one. You don't really have them at the beginning of the game, you have to unlock them. There are some others that I don't have myself on the Steam account, but if you play it, you will get there. You can also skill your character, but I won't do this right now because I want to show you that you can do it without these skills. Some of them are a bit OP, so. Let's go. I won't show you the campaign. There's a campaign in the game, but I want you to check it out for yourself. If there are some requests, maybe I will do it, but for now, I just want to show you how to play the game. So this is the menu where you can choose your mission. There are a lot of them. Obviously, some of them are just for me testing. Today I want to show you this one because it's the one most players start with and some of the players have trouble with it. There are three spawners like you can see here. One is over there, one is over there, and one is over there. This is a normal forest biome, so you can build everything. On some biomes like the desert, the snow, and the volcano, there are restrictions. In this one you don't have any plants, any trees or water, so this is relatively difficult, where this one is pretty easy. Because I'm good, I will play this on a very high difficulty. I will leave the peace time as it is because it's extremely hard if you do this with zero and nightmare. It's possible, but for the sake of completing the mission, I won't do it. Because I'm playing on Nightmare, I will leave this as slow, so enemies will spawn like every, I think, 5 minutes or so. If you increase this, it's like 4, 3, 2 minutes or something. I don't really know, but you can read it if you want to know exactly. This one I will leave as well, and start gold. This is the default. You can even start with zero, but I will leave it. We can ignore this in single player, and I will change my color to green because I like green. There are some other maps in the workshop. Some of them are totally crazy, like this one. This has over 20 spawners. So if you're really good and you are up for a challenge, you can check these ones out. So let's go. Like you can see, we start on this big area where no terrain is generated, and this is where we can build our city. Like you can see, there's a spawner, one is over there and one is over there. And yeah, this is where the enemies will come from. We have this rock on our area right here, and this rock is very important because this is where we can place our quarry. The quarry is obviously important to generate stones, and these trees over here are good for generating wood. So to start, you can check out the lower right corner. We have to press B to get into the build menu. There is another option. If you press F1, you can get into this view, but I prefer the one from straight top. The most optimal way is to actually place your stockpile right in front of this quarry because you get the most stone and iron from it. Before you can build anything else, you have to build this main building and the stockpile. The stockpile is over in this resource thing. Many people have struggled to find it at the first time. Yeah, so you just select the building and left click to place it. You can also press R to rotate. Like you can see, there is a builder guy right now. If you build a stockpile, there you get one builder for free. For every other one, you have to pay. These buildings are there instantly, they don't cost anything. But if you place something like a woodcutter, there is this box, and your builders or yourself have to build it. Above, you can see how much resources it will take to be finished. This guy now will walk back and forth to get a resource and play a little animation. You can also build yourself. You just press on the box, go to the stockpile, and then go over here again, and you will help to build it. But I'm lazy, I don't like to do this, so I will look how they do it. Now, because we have a woodcutter hut, there is a woodcutter, he will automatically gather wood for us. We can also do this by ourselves. If you go to a tree, you can press E and the guy will chop down this tree. When you press I, you have your inventory. This one is the stockpile, the city's inventory, and this one is yours. Now we have trunks. In order to make them to wood, we have to go to the heart of this guy and use a saw to make it to planks. So after we do this, now we have wood and we can give the wood to our stockpile. Same thing with this guy. He will produce stone for us, and he has I think 20% chance to generate iron at the same time. We can also get stone from here, but it's really slow, so only do it if you need money or you need a lot of stones, because this guy will produce 3 stones per harvest and you only get 1. Now, like you can see up here, we will need food and water. In order to get water, we place a well. In order to get food, you can either place those chicken farms, or if you want to really go crazy, you go with wheat, because wheat only needs 2 workers and produces a lot more than the chicken farms. On some maps, you don't have to wheat, or if you make a really big population, you will need both. You have to place those wheat fields. You don't have to use all 12 at once, but I like to do that. In order to harvest it, you will need the windmill, because the windmill will spawn the farmer guy who walks over there and harvests it. Now, if you just do that, you will produce wheat. The wheat can't be eaten, so you have to get a bakery as well to make bread from it. I like to place the bakery close to the stockpile, because she will walk there, get the wheat and walk back. And this guy has to wait for the wheat to grow, so most of the time he will stand around and do nothing anyway. So he will... it's not too bad that he is far away. We only have 1 worker right now, and this is very slow because we play on a high difficulty. We want to place some more houses, and if you press priority right here and click on a building, you can tell him what he should build next, because we really have to speed up the game. We help him right now because we need more builders in order to get done before the peace time that's over here, over there, is done. If this is finished, or if this is at 0, enemies will spawn, and because I play on Nightmare, they really hurt. So even the easiest enemies do crazy amount of damage. So you really want to have at least some archers. So So we have two houses now. Our max amount of villagers is increased. By the way, this is how many villagers you have with no work. So if I recruit some workers, this will go down. This is how many villagers you have total, and this is how many you can have. So yeah, like you can see, this will go a lot faster because five people will now work at once. Yes. Next, I like to produce some beer because beer makes people happy. Oops. And we want them to be happy in order to get their money because you need money to get some military going. And obviously we want this. Next, I will place the smithy because you can upgrade your units with the smithy and this takes some time, so better place it earlier than later. Next, I will place the sheep farm and the tailory because they will produce some clothing and you can also make villagers happy with clothing. Don't ask how, but this is how the game works. I know I created it, but now I will concentrate on building some walls around here because my people don't defend themselves if you don't have any archers or so. So let's get some walls going. I will I will leave some space for other buildings so I don't have to place anything outside. Now I will go and build more houses. I also want a graveyard. If I die, I can respawn over here, and I want a market as well, just in case I need something important. Now is the time to build the barracks. The barracks are there to recruit military units, so if you don't have them, you can't even get anything. Hopefully, I did everything in the correct order, otherwise, I will have some serious problems later. Now I will place the other food sources just to get more food because if you have enough food, you can increase the rates, and this allows you to actually increase the happiness as well. Now I want to build a church. The church is also good for happiness, and you can recruit monks over there. The monks will buff your military units. I think I built everything over here. I could build another woodcutter because why not? And this is almost it. Now you want to get as many villagers as possible because at this point you will actually want a big army. And as more villagers you have, as bigger your army can be. So this is everything you can build except for the workshop. The workshop allows you to upgrade your buildings, but it's super expensive, like you can see here. So I will build this if everything else is done because I want to move these trees inside of my castle that I can close the door and no enemy will be able to get in. So now what we have to do is to wait until these guys build everything. Like you can see, we are low on wood, so maybe I want to get the woodcutter earlier. I could tell them to build this thing first, but because it's so cheap, I will just build it by myself. Same here, I could help them gathering trees, but you yourself get only one tree, or one wood per tree. And because these guys here are specialists, they get two or three, I'm not so sure actually, per tree. Like you can see, there's something going on here. This one is the bakeress. She does produce bread from the wheat. Our blacksmith is done also, so I want to select the archer. You can upgrade the other units as well, but always go with the archer first. I will straight upgrade it to level 10, so this guy will walk over here, get some iron, and it takes 45 seconds per upgrade if you are not skilled in any way. This is the well worker. He will just wait until this well is full, and if it is, he will produce some water. We can see now. You will need water and food in order for your people to be happy. The food situation is not as good as the water, because you get a lot of water per thing. I think it's like 8 or 9 water per cycle, and the food is like 3 or so per wheat. By the way, you can also harvest the wheat if the other guy is too slow, but because the baker is and needs to wait anyways, we don't have to do it. You can also, if you don't have the people to get your windmill up, you can harvest yourself and just make the bakerist. But I want to automate as much as possible, so I'm lazy and I want my people to do the work. Like you can see over here, this is the brewery. This girl will harvest those hops and create beer from it, like you can see over there. Now she's done, she will go over to the stockpile, and our beer amount will increase. Now we can actually get our beer up by 1 and get some money from it. If you press H, you can see how happy your villagers are. So we get 2 because we have food, -3 for the taxes, and +2 for the beer. As you can see, there are some messages down there that means that we have to build more houses, because this guy and this guy want to recruit their workers, and they can't because we don't have enough houses. Because my guys are very busy and we have not so much more time before enemies come, I will do it by myself. Because we really want as much walls as possible before enemies are here, that they can't get inside. Some enemies can ignore walls, like there are some birds or spiders that can get over the walls, but at the beginning the normal enemies will just wait outside and get shot by your archers if you have some. Because we don't have a fully built wall, we will have some trouble in 20 seconds, because enemies will get inside and attack our units. And because I'm relatively weak, I can't do anything about it. But if I manage to defeat the first few enemies, my guys, there we go, will build the wall before the second wave is there. So because I know where these guys are coming from, I will just attack him. I really don't want to get hit by this guy, because like I said, we play on a really hard difficulty and he will hurt a lot. Like you can see at over here, we have some armor, so we can take 2 hits without getting any damage. And only if the armor is gone, we will take damage. But I really don't want to waste my armor for some stupid foxes. So better be careful. We also have some skills, like you can see down there. This is the one skill. So this one you activated with the key 1, this is 2, you throw your sword, And I will show you free if we get the last enemy, because the one on free has a long cooldown. So this is the guy from the big spawner over there, the goblin. This one is a boss spawner, by the way. So an ogre will come out of there at wave 10, or if we attack it and it has low life. So in order to not get hit, you actually want to roll. You can roll with right click to cancel your animation, and this way you can actually dodge many of the attacks from them. Because we play on slow, we can chill a little bit. If you would play on medium or even fast wave speed, you should actually get units before you get your wall, because otherwise you won't have any chance of defeating the enemies. With the nightmare difficulty, you actually can't just attack the spawners, because otherwise you will straight die. So you have to get a little bit creative. On some maps there are multiple spawners at one place, so if you have this situation, you really have to look what you are doing, because you obviously don't want to attack multiple spawners at once if you play on a high difficulty, because they will just destroy your whole army and it's not a fun time for everyone. Two more. Like you can see, my wall is almost finished and enemies will basically only be able to come through this gate, and you can close this gate, and if it's closed, most enemies won't be able to get inside of your castle, at least at the beginning. Like I said, later on enemies will be able to fly or go over your castle, and some enemies can even destroy your walls. So like in this one, the ogre can obviously destroy walls, and there are also some catapults and other things that can do this. So let's spend all our money. With the tab key, you can go in this view and you can control your units. Another option is to press space in the third person view and space again to send these guys around. Now we are at a point where we don't have enough money to recruit other people, because we now have clothing. We can increase the taxes again, like you can see over here. As higher you make this, as faster you get money, and as more people you have, as faster you get money too. So if you have the max amount of people, which is 45, I think, and you have this on 5, you will get money like zack, 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 zack. But we are not at this point right now. Because we have a lot of food, we can also get this one up one higher. We also have the chicken farm right now, but we don't have enough people to actually use it. So please, guys, build the houses first. If you forgot what you built where, you can obviously read it over there. The house 2 is just a bigger version of this house, but it's also more expensive. So I could tell that they have to build this one first. I want to show you the other buildings too. This one is the graveyard. Like I said, if you die, you will spawn over here. If you don't have a graveyard, you lost. So always make sure to have one, and just pro tip, build it like in the middle of your castle, because if there are catapults or other enemies and you have this one like over there, they will just destroy it and you lose very fast. This is the market. You can buy and sell your stuff over here. You can also buy some potions. Maybe you have seen you start with some potions. If you are low on health, you can press 4 and use the health potions or 5 for the mana potion. With this character class, mana potions are not that interesting. Of course, you will need mana, like you can see, but normally you don't need that much mana that your thing goes down. With other classes like the mage, there are situations where you want to use your mana potions. You can have 10 of everyone, but they are quite expensive. Yeah, you can, by the way, also press this guy from above and interact with him like this. The same is with this guy, these two, and the blacksmith as well. We can check it out. He is actually done. I want to upgrade the healer next. I have enough iron. If you are low on iron, maybe you want to consider to buy some. Because without iron, he will obviously not continue building. I always get two healers because healers can't heal themselves. Let's close the gate. Send these guys over here. Healers can't heal themselves, so you always want a second one that can heal the first one, and the first one can heal the second one. Just in case they get damaged. Like you can see, there is a fox over here and he can't get inside because I closed the gate. Now, obviously, my people won't be able to go outside. This guy will try to get as close as possible to the tree, but obviously, he won't get there and he will just get teleported back because he can't find his way. Guys. If your archers are on top of a wall or on top of a tower, they will get a higher range on the tower, even higher as on the gatehouse or on the wall. And if they are on the ground, obviously this gets reset. What you can also do if you have your guys selected, there are two different attack states. This one is a defensive one, so for these guys, they will stand here and never leave. And only attack if enemies are like in their face. This is very good, very useful for this difficulty because you can place these guys like here, have your healers behind and your archers over here, and these guys will never actually walk towards this thing and die. But by default, they are in this attack state. Same with the archers. You can have them in the defense state so they don't try to walk. Like you can see, there is an earthquake right now. This will damage our buildings. Maybe we will see it like over there. This one gets a bit red. This means it is damaged, this one as well. You can actually repair them in the build menu. Maybe you have seen it. You can here click repair one or repair all. There can be some problems with this, like maybe this one, if the builders try to repair it, they will maybe get stuck because they can't reach it. Yes, because nothing got damaged too crazy, I want repaired because I want my guys to actually focus on other things like those trees. Like you can see, there's another fox. He just waited at a spawner because the door was closed, and now the door is opened, and he will try to get over here again. You, at the later state of the game, you want your trees to be inside, because obviously you can just close the doors, and your workers won't try to get outside then. Now we have a little bit more money. I also want to build this thing. This is the Hero Guild. You can recruit crazy powerful units over here. and you really need, you don't really need them, but they are pretty good to have. There is another goblin, but our archers take care of this, of him. Oh, this one I almost forgot. Where did he go? This is a thief. He will spawn on hard difficulty or higher. And he will just try to steal stuff from you. No, like you can hear, our church is done. This one will actually increase our happiness depending on how many people you have. And you can also recruit monks. They will buff your units. Let's check this out. He's only at 5. Because he's only at 5, we might have some problems with attacking. Because stop. Because our guys are not tanky enough, but let's see. Let's get another one. Some units like boars can actually run through your through your tanks like this one. And attack your healers or your archers, so you have to be careful with that. I will actually close the door just in case enemies will spawn that they don't get inside. So let's select these guys, make them on passive, place them over here, get our healer, place them over here, because they have to be able to heal, otherwise these guys will be dead very fast. So let's get our archers. I only want the archers to attack units that are already out of there, because I want my catapults to deal damage. Guys, stop. To deal damage to this thing. I actually want more catapults. Go. I need money. Thank you. Because they are not skilled and they won't deal enough damage. Guys, you are so stupid. Yes. Like you can see, the catapults will actually... I almost fell. Will actually attack the spawner. And these guys are just there to actually kill the enemies that come out of there. I want to place them a little bit like this, that they... What? Why? Oh shit. Seems to be another goblin inside there. Dude, why? How? That hurts, because they are very expensive. But we should be good anyways. Yeah, this might take some time now, so maybe I want to place... Maybe I want to place some of them in front of there, just to help out. Like you can see, now there are other enemies, like those wolves here, attacking. And because these guys here are taking care of this, I want to actually defend the rest of my castle. Like you can see over there, at this wave there will be birds, and those birds will be able to actually attack or fly on top of the walls. Let's kill those guys. And not... Oh, like can see these guys deal a ton of damage. I only got hit twice and I'm almost dead. And now I want those birds to get to me, that I can actually damage them. And there's a goblin as well. The birds can be hard to hit as a melee fighter, but it's definitely possible, like you can see. It can actually be a little bit annoying, but some enemies have to be annoying, I think. Dude, can you please stop being an asshole? Like you can see, you also get money from killing enemies. So if your economy is not so good, you can also attack very early and get money from that. Come on. Dude. I now have a lot more money, so I can get a few more catapults. And, oh, the workshop is not done. Thank you. Gosh. So, let's go over here again and attack the spawner. Basically, it's the same thing with all the spawners. You want to have your healers behind, your knights or tanks in front, and your archers or attacking units at the back, that they don't get hurt. Yes. The only thing that makes this tactic a little bit difficult is if you are, guys, if you're fighting against some bosses, because the bosses have a lot higher range and they will just kill all your units at once. So because I have so much of it, I will just sell some stone, and now we have to wait until this is done and this is done. My castle was infested by bugs. See, maybe we can see them. Oh, yeah, here they are. I don't know if you can actually see this on YouTube, but there are some black bugs that just do destroy our plants. These are the spiders. If you have them at your castle, they can just climb your walls. So you want to kill them as fast as possible. I want to skill myself as well, that I deal more damage. Like you can see, the spiders will actually throw some green stuff. This stuff will poison you and your units and will deal damage over time. I haven't paid attention. Is this guy actually done? Yes, he is. Please upgrade the soldiers. If you upgrade them, they will get more damage and more health as well. So it's obviously very useful to upgrade them. These guys are stupid again. Can you please get over there? Thank you. Deal some damage to this thing. Obviously you want to destroy the spawners as fast as possible. Holy shit. That they won't attack your castle. In the best case scenario, you want to actually destroy the more threatening spawners like this one first, because there will be catapults coming out of there, and they will just melt down your castle if you're not careful. The catapults have screwed me up a lot of times, because they have a lot higher range than the archers. Even if they stay on top of the towers, the range is about the same, and the catapults one-shot your almost all your units at high difficulty. And if they attack with catapults, it's like this, they have like 5 or 10 of them at once, and this really hurts. Oh my guy will die, shit, because he's not upgraded yet. He doesn't have that much health. Because they got pushed around, I want to reorder these guys over here. And the earthquake destroyed my hops. That's not that big of a deal. Please heal my soldiers. Thank you. As we are going, the soldiers are getting stronger and stronger because they get more health. The blacksmith does actually increase their damage while we are talking, increase their health, so they get actually stronger. I'm out of potions, so I have to be a little bit more careful now. But I have to help, otherwise my guys will actually die. I mean, they already die, but more of them will die. Okay, I actually want to go back a little bit to... Oh, shit. I forgot to close the game. This is bad. Let me in. Okay, nice. The bigger dots on the map, by the way, are the birds. And if a unit dies, you can recruit them over here, and they will automatically find their find a new place to work. In this case, it should be a little bit easier to kill these because we have some archers in here. Can you please? Fuck off. This guy is just the troll. Okay, yes. Oh, this thing is done. What I want to do now is to upgrade my buildings that I can have even more villagers. You can only do this if you have the workshop, and I will actually buy some potions. There we go. And I actually made a mistake. I don't want to recruit archers, I want to recruit the soldiers. Or in this case, I actually want to recruit my heroes over here. And these are created from, or not from, because of some players that really helped me developing, or help me in some other way. And oh, there are the bugs again. Oh shit. And I'm thankful for them helping me. So So this one is Günther. He's riding a pig, because why not? And the other guy is called Mozzoknir. It is a reference to the dwarf from Lord of the Rings, like you can maybe see. And he has a badass axe. Both of them you can only recruit once, but they are extremely strong. You can't upgrade them, but actually you don't even need to, because like I said, they are super strong. This guy, they also have some skills. Are you kidding me? They also have some skills. Like Günther can spawn some other pigs, some ghost pigs that will tank some hits, and Mozzoknir will throw some bombs. They have also some special attack, like he can throw his shield, and the other guy can stun or taunt some enemies because he's super tanky. If you can, you always want to recruit those two guys, because like I said, they are super strong. On easy difficulty, he can even destroy a spawner solo. If you have a healer behind him, it will take a while, but he can easily do it. Because the spawner is super low, I just want to destroy it now as fast as possible. So I will have my archers attack there too. Like you can see, Günther is throwing his sword. This was Mozzoknir's bomb. It does a ton of damage and does some nice AoE damage as well. This attack, I think it's really funny. It does stun the enemies, and yeah, stuns the enemies and does some damage obviously too. Because the spawner's almost done, I will help to attack. There will be one more wave of enemies coming, or not. Never mind. The same tactics over here, just with the catapult, without the catapults. Like you can see, the archers will kill the lower enemies very fast. But if there are more enemies and stronger enemies, this won't be that easy. I will move these guys back a little bit, just because if the ogre comes out of there, you really don't want them to be close together, these guys as well, because the ogre does a ton of damage obviously, and he does some really big AoE damage. Oh, like you can see, these are the ghost pigs he does spawn. There's the bomb again. And they will basically just tank and help to attack a little bit. He won't spawn them too often. At an earlier version of the game, I had them spawn like way too often, and it was crazy OP. I want him to stay inside of the range of the healers, obviously. Because I don't want him to die. Like I said, you can't recruit him again. And if they die, if both of them die, the game is a lot harder. This is his taunt animation. So if there's an enemy attacking, like for example him, and he does his taunt animation, he will change his target. But that's not so useful most of the times. Like you can see, if you have your army ready and all of them are skilled to the max, do you attack? No. It's not too hard anymore. You will just rush through there. Obviously, in the campaign, there are some other missions where you can make your life a lot harder. Like no resources at the beginning, or other stuff. And if you want to, you can make the waves faster, so it's a lot harder. And increase the wave speed and stuff like that. Obviously, other maps are way harder. Like I mentioned, there are maps with 6 spawners, 7 spawners, or in the Steam Workshop, even like 25 or something. That's really crazy. There is our ogre. I try my best to tank him or to make him attack me, because my archers can actually attack him without anyone getting damaged in the process. You have to be really careful. I think if he hits me with one of its attack, I'm dead. Even though I'm the tankiest character class, he does a lot of damage. Okay, maybe I can tank 2 hits, but he hit me there with his foot. And you don't want to tank this. He's also able. Yes, this one is done. He's also able to call units, like you can see here. He will spawn some goblins. Yes, and now he's dead. Actually, if you play this for your first time or so, if you kill this guy on hard difficulty, he will give you an achievement. And let's do the same thing again. This guy. This guy. And my healers. Like you can see, he is super duper fast. We're getting attacked, but I don't really care too much about it. Because the game is almost over, I can just ignore this. You have to be really careful with this. If you are low on resources and your guys die, your villagers will be unhappy. And if they are unhappy, they will leave the castle. Even your army will leave the castle. So be careful with that. Oh yeah, all my guys die. But like I said, I'm not too worried about that, because if I destroy this spawner over here, the game is over anyway. The ogre is one of the easier bosses. There are other bosses, especially in the campaign, that are significantly harder. There's, for example, a wyvern who can fly into your castle and basically destroy everything. And there are some other units that will kill your whole army at once. So let's just look at this. It won't take too long to actually destroy this, because my units are all very strong. Now the pigs even go to attack. That's very useful, because now the enemies will be blocked a little bit. Let's help them to. Oh, that's. I thought that's an enemy, but it's. It's his war. Like you can see, they can actually push you around. I'm poisoned now. And you really want to be careful, because if you land inside of that water over there, you are dead. I think almost my whole population should be dead right now. Oh, there are. Tank it. Obviously, you can do everything from this perspective as well. It doesn't show the thing down here. I should actually add this, but you can also play the game from this perspective if you really want. It can be cool, but especially if you want to build something, it can be a little bit tricky, and I don't know how to fix this. I played around with the angle a little bit and couldn't actually manage to make it work 100%. Could you stop pushing my units around? Thank you. That's what I said, this healer is now damaged, and if you only have one, he will stay at this and he will die eventually. So always make sure to have a second healer on you. If you play as another character class like the archer or the mage, you could just stay here and shoot at this thing. It would be a lot faster. And there we go. I won. I earned almost 80k gold. Lost 44 units. Killed 263 and destroyed all three spawners. So over there you can read the map name and so on. If there are multiple players, there are stats for every player that is in the game. So you can compare with your friends. And for winning the game, I got a little bit XP because I'm a very high level. I don't get too much, or it's not too much because you need a lot to finish it, but that was it. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to leave me a like, and maybe if you are really interested at the game, you can buy it at the Steam store or on itch. I will leave links to it in the descriptions, and have a nice weekend. Stay healthy. Ciao.